What is the truth? The real churches are a place for worshiping the God and Jesus, but don't forget that it stands in the Bible about false priests and false churches. In real churches, there is Holy Spirit and angels who are the witness of prayers. The Holy Spirit sends His Holy over each church during or after the service. Of course, there are few visitors who make or has made sins. Therefore, everybody receives the Spirit, especially if they confess their sin from the heart and soul. What you have with Jesus is very greater than your past and what you have. Ebranian 2:1. We must listen correctly what we hear from Christ and be clever. Be aware of Satan and his devil in this world because they work to destroy your belief. Therefore, understand God's words and obey. Don't forget that your body has been washed during baptized. Learn and teach each other. Join people to God's imperium. Ask God for help when you invite people to Him. He helps you to use His words in proper way. Ebranians 12:21. Keep your eyes on Jesus, especially when you talk with Him. Be concentrated and focus on what you pray or tell. Unfortunately, my brain occupied, but I must ask Jesus and God to free me before I start my worship. Jesus guides you and helps you. Trust on Him and listen to Him. Amen. Think on Jesus and adore His patience with the sinners. Don't give up as like as Jesus didn't. Don't be tired as like as Jesus didn't. Ebranians 1, God's kindness is that He sent us many prophets with scriptures to rescue us from our sins, but we humans sinned again. He sent us a beloved Son, Jesus, to restore us to God's imperium, but they crucified Him. God's power made the big tragedy as a victory for Jesus by raising Him from the dead and giving Him power to judge us. This is one of His heritage from the Father God, who so ever believe on Him and obey Him and get eternal life. God's love is that He has talked and talking with us in different ways. Even in the terrible situation, He talks to decrease the pain and fear. Example is when a bush burned in front of Moses, but God talked with Moses to eliminate the fear. As like as God talked with me in the most terrible situation and learned me. Pray that God's words break in your body and mind. Therefore, Jesus get us bread, words, and the wine, His blood, to keep the words effective. Amen. If your knowledge is incomplete, search in the scripture. If a question appears, ask to get an answer, because maybe when you die, you must answer. Questions to be raised from the dead. When you join Jesus, He has power on you because Jesus owns everything in this world and has power. Of course, Satan works to keep people apart from Jesus. But when you believe that Jesus is in you and you in Jesus, then you are safe. When you know the real love, then you reject Satan and keep you closer to God and Jesus. Don't forget, if you sin, Jesus finds Himself unhappy, followed by your soul and spirit in trouble. When you love Jesus, then let Him enjoy His stay at you. God is the light and Jesus is its radiation and flash. Very beautiful. God sent prophets in different times to rejoice us to Him. When the world developed, He, God sent Jesus to complete his will and grace, which makes us holy and know him as a very kind, lovely, careful, and faithful creator. Jesus, Son of God, was God because he was in God and God in him. Then everything we saw and heard is God's actions and words. He learned people the correct way of living and helping each other to see the truth and be guided by Jesus, for he is the real shepherd. Everything we see in this world has a very beautiful harmony, which is a picture of God's love. When you see painting, you can find the love. Then when you cannot see God's love in his creation, as the same as you try to keep safe your belongs from Jesus and God, keep the creation from demons and evils and Satan, then understand God's commandments and obey to stay in the right path. Always ask God for strength and straight your hand to Jesus and ask him, keep your hand to guide you safe. The life with Jesus is much better than your past without Jesus. Believe and trust. Amen. Ebranian 1, think on your end time of life. Think what is left to do. If someone asks you about your family member, how do you answer? The answer is based on your belief on Jesus and your Christ knowledge. If you have only a weak knowledge on Jesus, then it is only an experience of Christ, not the real knowledge on him. Deeper you educate on Christ, more happiness and humanity increases in your soul and life. If you step with Jesus in the name of, in the same way he has stepped, then you are approved. God has only called Jesus the most important part of God's imperium and most higher of God as his son, who brings joy for God. To restore human to God, God didn't call an angel as his son, only that any angels who have wings and bring God's sins of on any human must praise Jesus, his son. God tells Jesus that his throne is eternal and very safe and beautiful. God tells Jesus that his throneship is justice and equity. God tells that Jesus loves devoutness and piety and that evils are his enemies. Therefore, God has polished Jesus with the original and heavenly lovely oil. God tells Jesus that the creation vanished and disappears, but you exist eternally. God tells Jesus that his place at him is right hand side of him to judge living and dead, that the enemies crushes under his throne. Amen. Hallelujah. As the same as these words are beautifully connected like a chain, you must use powerful words as chain, move and explain God's grace, which is making us holy. You are punished if you don't listen to angels. You are going to be punished stronger if you don't obey Jesus, who is greater than angels. You become free if you realize this and obey Jesus and angels who are bringing God's will. If you feel that you are chained, uncomfortable, then you have gotten God's words or commandments in wrong way. Sometimes the priest misunderstanding or integrity causes uncomfortable things, then read the scriptures by your own and with help of Jesus and Holy Spirit to find the rest and beauties of God's words, which are full of love. Ebrahians 2 Part 5. God has mentioned Jesus as his son 3 times before, during, and after his existence in this world. The most important is when he raised to heaven and is sitting at the right side of the God and judged the living and dead. Jesus calls the God as his father, and the God calls Jesus as his son. God demands the angels to praise and serve and support Jesus. Then we must praise and serve Jesus and be supported by Jesus. God has named Jesus God because Jesus is his only son and his only heir. Can you feel God's love? It stands that Jesus made the earth. Yes, because Jesus was with the God from the beginning, when God created universes. In different scriptures, God has mentioned Jesus as his son. In the beginning, God sent angels to learn Adam and Eva how they can make supplies for existence by using the nature. God has given human thinking abilities for developing the earth and change it as heaven, but Satan is in work too. Keep human apart the God. God has patience, and in correct timing, he sent us prophets to rescue us from demons, and that we adjust God's will in any situation. Jesus completes this adjustment by restoring lost human to God's kingdom. Jewish crucified Jesus and were happy to defeat the God and Jesus, but God made a victory by raising Jesus from the dead. Whoever believes in on him and obey him is going to be raised from the dead and get an eternal life. God mentions in the scripture that Jesus has control over the world. It appears the dictators and reign many years, and God has patience, but when they have gone over the boundaries, Jesus put his foot over their neck and presses to destroy them and rescue people, depending on how people fight for their rights and existence. Sometimes dictators live until their life is ended. Even then, Jesus presses their neck with his foot to stop the evil. It is only this life they had, and then they are dead, for they didn't obey the God. Trust Jesus and the God for control. Ebrahians 2 part 1 to part 4. We must pay more attention on what we read. Don't misunderstand and don't sleep. Otherwise, we haven't any secure and correct path. God has sent the prophets to guide us to the correct path, and let angels and Holy Spirit help us to understand and obey God's words and commandments. Then we must pay more attention to avoid deviation by keeping us closer to the God and Jesus, who was his last messenger and who complete God's purpose. There are almost Christians, they who go to the church and listen, but they don't bring it in their life. They are baby Christians. They who are born and are baptized and learn about Christ until they are adult. They are mature Christians, who are believer and active Christians. God talks with us via his prophets. He introduces himself to human and that he cares about us. He tells us that Jesus, his son, is greater than angels. We focus on the first group. To be a mature Christian, always ask God to write his commandments and words in your heart, mind, and soul to make our spirit strong, delighted, and holy. You must defer the angel's works and Jesus' works. What Jesus did and does is to restore us to the God's kingdom. He educated and educates us how we can reach the king, that kingdom, and how we can avoid deviation. The angels support us to keep us closer to the God and Jesus. But even angels bring us messages from the God and Jesus, while Jesus' messages are greater. Pay attention that angel messages have affection. Then you understand how great effect have Jesus' messages. It says that Moses' 10 God's law were the message from the angels. It calls legalized. When Moses came out from the Sinai mountain, he shined and he was holy, so that everybody could see the flesh, which was God's light. The stone covered by 10 God's law had such an effect that everybody felt. It stands that people killed the prophets and didn't obey the angels' messages, which was God's word, and they became condemned. Then you should know if we don't obey God's words. When God talked with us via Jesus, God was inside Jesus and Jesus inside the God, has a stronger punishment. All God's messages are full of love and faithfulness. Then how we cannot obey them? You must be as strong as Jesus, for Jesus live in you and you live in Jesus. Make the God and Jesus pleased to keep yourself closer to the God. Listen, read, and understand God's words and commandments, and obey. They make you free from any disasters and bring peace in your life and heart and become blessed. To be active, teach each others and guide them to the God and Jesus, the Savior. God's kindness and faithfulness is approved in any time and situation in this world. If you don't obey, you become rejected from God's imperium, while if you obey, you have a place in God's house and an eternal life. Jesus was bringing the good and lovely messages. God confirmed by letting Jesus does miracles, and the gifts from Holy Spirit are given to believers by replacing Jesus' soul in us. Hallelujah. Amen. As soon as you believe on God, Jesus, and the commandments, it flows a strong spirit inside you and you become holy. When you baptize, if you have sinned, then trust and confess with your whole heart and mind and join to the God by Jesus. You must differ between legalized and the Bible. If you keep yourself to legalize, you will be divided from the Bible. Keep yourself bonded to Bible and be blessed and holy. Bible brings life, but legality leads you to life. God's love and faithfulness to human is so beautiful and eternal, so that you find your safety in the Bible.